it's kind of hard to find. If you had to guess, how far do you think it is from Chicago to the center of Korea? How far? Over 100, definitely. What do you, you what?
100? Like 1,000 miles from Korea.
You've been to Korea?
Over 1,000 miles.
Over 1,000 miles.
Like 2 days ago.
It took like 2 days to get there? It's 6,000 miles away from here. It's pretty far. It's pretty far, yeah. Yeah, that would take a lot of days, absolutely. Pacific Islander Asian American Month. And our first story today is about a little girl from Korea. So, how many people like their name? Like their name. How many people would like to change their name if they could change their name? See, there always is. Was anybody named after somebody? Leslie, who were you named after?
Her grandfather.
Her grandfather. Otto, who were you named after? Your great-grandfather. So sometimes, Delina?
Your mother.
Your mother. Sometimes, yes.
Otto is named after his great-grandfather, his father, and his
grandmother. Oh, so it's a heavy burden you're carrying there, Otto. A heavy burden. Yes, Charlie.
Well, it's not even my grandfather.
It's a character from a book. Yeah. Well, you know what? My name is because my mom liked Maureen O'Hara. My name is Maureen. So, it's all for a reason. Yes.
The title.
You, Sebastian is your dad's middle name. Sebastian is your dad's middle name. Perfect. Well, I have a story today about a little girl who comes here from Korea, which we just saw is about 6,000 miles away from here. And let's hear what's going to happen to her, okay? All right. Hopefully you can all kind of see that. Through the school bus window, Yunhae looked out at the strange buildings and houses on the way to her new school. It was her first day, and she was both nervous and excited. She fingered the little block of wood in her pocket and remembered leaving her grandmother at the airport in Korea. Her grandmother gave her a little red pouch. Your name is inside, she said. Yunhae was confused.
She looked inside and she said, my name is inside? I don't quite understand.
But we will find out why her name was inside. Again, she took out the red pouch and looked at it in the wooden block with her name carved in it. As she ran her fingers along the grooves and ridges of the Korean characters, she pictured her grandmother's smile. Is that a thing for show and tell? A boy asked Yunhae, surprising her. Yunhae looked up, and the kids leaned over. No, it's mine, Yunhae said, quickly putting the pouch back into her pocket. Are you near new here? What's your name? A girl asked. Yunhae, she said. Unae, the girl said, scrunching up her face. Ew, Unae, she chanted. Oh no, Yunhae corrected. It's spelled U. H-E-I. It's pronounced Yunhae. Oh, Yunhae, the boy said, like, Yunhae, what about hey you? Just then the bus pulled up to the school and the doors opened. Yunhae hurried to get off. Yunhae, bye-bye, the kid yelled as she left. Yunhae felt herself blush. Yunhae stood in the doorway of her new and noisy classroom. She was relieved that the kids on the bus had gone to the other rooms. But her face still felt red. Aren't you going in? Asked the curly-haired boy with lots of dots on his face. You're the new girl, right? He asked cheerfully. Yunhae nodded, and before she could walk away, the boy took her hand and pulled her through the door. Here's the new girl, he announced so loudly that the teacher, Mr. Kopotas, almost dropped his glasses. Mr. Kopotas thanked him and greeted Yunhae.
Noble, our newest student, he said to the class. She and her family just arrived from Korea last week. Yoon-hae smiled broadly and tried not to show her nervousness. What's your name? Someone shouted. Yoon-hae pictured the kid on the cross. I haven't picked one yet, she said. She told the class, but I'll let you know by next week what my name is. As Mr. Kokoto showed her to her desk, she felt many round, curious eyes on her. Why doesn't she have a name? Someone whispered. Maybe she robbed a bank in Korea. Maybe we need a new identity, he said. On the bus ride home, nobody teased her, but Yoon-hae kept thinking about her name. How was school, Yoon-hae? Her mother asked when she walked in. Did you understand the teacher? Yoon-hae simply nodded. She unpacked her school bag and set up the red pouch by a photograph of her grandma. I'm glad you are learning English well, her mother said. You must study hard, behave nicely, and get good grades to show that you're a good Korean. I will, replied Yoon-hae. But I think I would like my new own American name, she said quickly. Her mother looked at her with a surprise. Why? Yoon-hae is a beautiful name. Your grandma and I went to a name master for it. But it's hard to pronounce, Yoon-hae, it complained. I don't want to be different from all the American kids. You are different, Yoon-hae, her mother said. That's a good thing. Yoon-hae just wrinkled up her nose. Later that day, Yoon-hae and her mother went to the grocery store in their new neighborhood. They passed the falafel place, they passed Tony's Pizza, they passed Dot's Deli, but then they came to Kim's Market, and she felt kind of like she was at home again, because it was in English and in Korean. It made her smile, because she liked to think that she would eat at least food that she knew. At the checkout counter, a friendly man said, are you helping your mom with the shopping? And Yoon-hae said, yes. I'm Mr. Kim, he said. And he said, what's your name? And she said, Yoon-hae. And he said, what a beautiful name. It means grace, doesn't it, in Korean? And she said, it does. But when she got home, she still was not convinced that that should be her name. So she practiced some new names in the mirror. Amanda? No. Maybe Laura? No, that didn't seem right. Maybe Susie? No, she wasn't sure about that. But the next day when she got to school, there was a special jar on her desk, and it said the name jar. And inside of there was all sorts of names that the kids had picked out for her. One of them was Wednesday. And she said, Wednesday? What's that? He said, because you came on a Wednesday. So I think that should be your name. And another one was Daisy. Daisy, he said, is my sister's name, and I think she would like you to share it. And another one was Park and Lex. And she said, why did you pick that? He said, those are my two favorite streets, so I think you would like it. So she said, all right, I'll think it over and look through those. After school, Joey, that boy with the freckles on his face, came up to her and said, what are you doing? And she had her little special pouch out, and she was stamping her name. She was stamping her name up, and he said, what does that say? She said, it's my name. He said, it's the most beautiful thing I have ever seen. The next day he came back, and there was more names in there. There was Rosie, there was Miranda, there was Stella, there was Avery. She couldn't decide which name to pick, but they all wanted her to pick their names. That day when she got home, while she was still deciding, there was a note from her grandmother. It said, to my Yoon-hae, I hope you are enjoying your new school and your new friends. Be sure to help your mother and your little brother. Here the moon is up, and by you the sun is up. No matter how far apart we are, no matter how different America is from Korea, you'll always be my Yoon-hae, her grandmother said. Well, the next day when Yoon-hae went to Mr. Kim's store, she saw Joey there, and she was very surprised that she was at Mr. Kim's market. And he was getting something special, but she didn't know what it was just then. Well, the next day when she came to school, the name jar was gone. She didn't know what to do. Everybody looked all over the classroom wondering what happened to the name jar. But she said, that's okay, because I've made a decision of what my name will be. She went up to the chalkboard and she wrote UNHEI. I liked all the names you chose, but I decided and I realized I'd like to keep my own name. So they practiced and practiced so they were able to say her name. And when she got home from school that day, Joey was waiting for her.
And Joey had the name jar.
And she said, "Why did you take the name jar?" He said, "Because I loved your name so much, I wanted you to stay with the name that you had." She said, "What were you doing at Mr. Kim's store the other day?" And he said, "I was getting my own stamp made so that I could stamp mine." And she said, "What does that say?" And he said, "Mine says Chinku, which means friend." Now, all of us have a different story to tell, and we're going to be hearing some different stories throughout this month. But we all have little pieces that make up our story. And not all of our pieces fit together the same way, do they? All of our stories are different. What's important is that our pieces fit together the way they're supposed to, the parts that we have from the past, the parts that we have now, and the parts that are coming. And God calls us to be able to fit our parts in with those all around us. Let us pray. Dear God, you have called us all by the same name. Children of God, we are so glad to be your child, and we embrace who we are, where we've came from, and where we are going. Help us to embrace that with everyone we meet new, in our classrooms, in our work, in our neighborhood, in our church. Help our pieces to all fit together to be a world of peace.